Everybody, welcome back to the Air of Authority. My name is Andrea, and today I'm going to share with you some really quick and easy tips on some settings that you can manipulate on your heating and air conditioning system that will help to combat viruses, illnesses, bacteria, any nasty stuff that might be circulating throughout the air in your house. We want to try to keep you as healthy as possible during this time, so I hope that these tips are helpful. If they are, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe. So let's get into our tips. My first tip is really super easy. The most popular furnace that we install has a variable drive furnace blower. And so what you want to do is go to your thermostat where there's a switch that says either auto or on. Switch that to the on position. That means that it's going to circulate the air continuously throughout your house. What we're trying to do is we're trying to gather up all the air from your house as much as possible and run it through your filtration system and then possibly your UV sterilization system and humidification as well. If you don't have anything else other than just a regular furnace filter, let's make sure that it's circulating through that filter as much as possible to try to eliminate viruses, bacteria, stuff like that. Another thing that you can do is if you have a humidifier, to keep it set at between 40 and 50%, that's when viruses are the least viable in that type of humidity. So 40 to 50%, you don't want to go crazy and don't set it up too high because that just creates other problems for you. So 40 to 50% on the humidifier in your home, that should be as helpful as possible in eliminating viruses in your home. If you have an electronic air cleaner like a micro power guard, you want to make sure that that media is changed 2 to 3 times per year. So if you haven't done that in a while, this would be a fantastic time to change that out. It depends on the type of house that you have. If you live in a house like me with kids, pets even, you might want to change that more 3 times a year. If you have a house with no pets, maybe just 2 people living there, you're totally fine with changing that 2 times a year. But if you haven't done it in a while, this would be the time to do it. Now, if you have a UV light sterilization system, that is awesome. The most popular one that we install with our company is the Oxyquantum LED UV light, and it has 2 bulbs, and those 2 bulbs need to be changed every 2 years. So it might look like it's on and working, but if the bulbs haven't been changed in 3-4 years, it's not being as effective, it's not being as strong as you want it to be right now to kill viruses and bacteria. So it's important to have your heating and air conditioning maintenance done and make sure that they change those UV bulbs to make sure that they're as powerful as possible. The main thing that you want to keep in mind is that if air is not circulating throughout your house, that it's not filtrating. Make sure that you change that setting on your thermostat to on to make sure that the blower is continuously running, and so that means that the air is continuing to be filtrated throughout your house. Change those filters, change the UV bulbs, make sure that they are fresh. So if you do all those things, you'll be doing everything that you can indoor air quality wise to prevent viruses in your home. So I hope that this was helpful. I hope that you're staying healthy and safe, and please let us know in the comments if you have any other questions. Please like and subscribe if this was useful for you, and we will see you soon. Thanks a lot.